Hi guys, Michael here. For recording I needed a bass tone with a little bit of distortion. So something like this. It's from the new Periphery record. And it seems to be quite interesting for a lot of people today. For example, shortly Loan Equivalon. Sorry if I don't pronounce it correctly, please correct me. He did a cover of Periphery of the Marigold and also posted the impulse response of his Darkless B3K, which he used for that, and his Ding Walls. In the cover, I don't have a Dingwall, so I wanted to go for the cheap solution to get satisfiable tone, which adds a little bit of this grind. So what I'm using here is a cheap PV Millennium BXP bass 5-string directly into the Helix. The Helix via SPD into Sapphire Pro, and that's what you're hearing. And also you will get a little bit of the clunk from the microphone. This is the patch I came up with. So the basic idea behind this patch is that in mixing you normally it's a very standard technique to use two tracks for the bass, one only process the lows and then one on the mids and the highs. And it's a cool technique, and then you can blend them to taste. And so with Helix you can do that too. So I just wanted to try it, and that's what I came up with. So first is it's the raw bass. Just going in, I have the input gate on, there are some background noises that children are playing in the neighbor room. So sorry for that. So this is the DI bass. It's currently tuned to F sharp for matching up with the 8 string. So first thing, this is the DI bass. Then the next is simple compression. It's on the compress setting quite high, emphasis turned down, just to get the peaks. And the bass is a very dynamic instrument, to get the peaks a little bit under control, so that it's a little bit more, it's more compressed, more solid. The next thing is then the amp, which I used the Kali 400 Channel 2 model, with a quite low drive. I don't want to add the drive here. If you add the drive to the bass also, it will, if it's too high, it will get squashy, muddy, and all sorts of things. That's why we have this processing here in the first place. So it gives also a little bit coloration to the tone already. A little bit of drive in the lows then. Okay, and then the main thing here is then the split. So here is this path for the lows, this path is for the mids and the highs, and I have just in the moment the lows up, so that we don't get this confused by the tones. So the next thing is, of course, we want only the lows, so to low pass. And so this is a low cut, high cut, and low cut is not used, and the high cut is set to the minimum setting that's possible, and it's 1k. It's a little bit too high for my taste, but we can also go lower then afterwards with the cap. So it's already filtering out a lot of highs. So tone is more bassy and solid. And then we have a 115 cabinet, and with a 4038 ribbon microphone. And here is the, interestingly, the high cut can here be turned down to 500. That's what I did. It's the lowest setting. If I go here, then we get a really bassy tone without much highs. And yeah, then to tame the low end, I really squash the signal with a limiter with the highest peak reduction, and the emphasis quite down. play with the fingers, then the clickiness of the microphone is then not so high. So. Yeah, so really busy. Okay, so let's turn that off and go to the highs. So we go from the amp here to another equalizer. And this time we do a low cut. High cut is off. And on 550 hertz. So everything below 550 will be filtered out with a certain steepness. Sounds a little bit strange for a bass. It sounds like this. Basically, you get the overtones without the fundamentals. And then the thing is, just we go into this distortion, and that's what makes then the crunchy sound. And you have quite several cool options with the Helix, and I tried several, and finally I settled with the valve driver, the gain full up, bass turned down. Yeah, and if I turn it on, then it's a little bit nasty. Yeah, so we need a cap, and this is the 8x10 cap with a 47 condenser mic, and I think the other settings are quite normal. And if I turn this on, then we get this sound. Yep, and so the trick is then, of course, to mix the two together, the bass. The more clean bass and the distorted highs. So let's go. I was at I think minus 3.3, something like that. Yep. Yeah. Yep. And then let's see how that sounds. So you get it at the basses itself, the lows are quite clean, or more clean, and then the mids and highs are more distorted. So this gives a little bit more definition to the bass. And so this is the basic patch, and then you can do a lot of it, another processing. So one thing I did was another equalizer, basic, so filter out minus 6 dB at 62.5 hertz, because that is the range where normally the kick has its fundamentals. A little bit of 125 pulled out. There were some, a little bit of resonant there. Then the low mids with 500 filtered out for the mud, the anti-mud treatment, a little bit of 2K and 4K, just a little bit. Yeah, so that's then the tone, and you can use it for different styles, even for more some punky styles. And punk metal gent, whatever, and with the distortion it blends quite nicely in the mix. That's one of the main reasons that in metal you distort the tone of the bass this way. Okay, and then you have, of course, you have cool options. So for example, change that to, for example, the Timmy is quite cool, I thought. So I get another kind of distortion. Or if you want to go extreme, you can also do not a distortion, but an amp, a guitar amp. It's also, tried a few, for example, I don't have the processing power anymore, but if I would use the second one, we can use all of them. But for example, the Line 6 Fatality is quite cool. So let's get the distortion up, the bass a little bit down. Yeah, so options are limitless, and you can play and equalize it, add effects, add chorus, whatever you like. So that's a basic patch with which I will do some recording. And so let's have a look how it sounds in a mix. Okay, so this is a song I recorded 1.5 years ago. I muted the original bass tracks, and now we'll record with this patch a little bit of it. And I've already tried a little bit, and we'll turn the plugins off. And just see how it sounds. Okay, so you see how that works. Of course I made some mistakes, and I wouldn't do that for the complete process. Let's just listen a little bit. Okay, and of course for a mix this is not enough, and this is also just a quick thing, so I did just a few equalization, a little bit of low pass, pulled some frequencies out, and then put a limiter on, so let's see how this sounds. And of course I should be a little bit more of a steadier player. Yeah, I'm not a bass player in the first thing, so. But it's definitely usable, and yeah, I think it's a quite cool patch. Okay, so one thing I forgot. So in the example, you heard a little bit of a pumping of the bass, and also the compression setting are not optimal. You can't set the attack and release times on the compressors on the Helix. So that's the thing. So the next thing I would do would be to tweak the compressor settings until you get a more sustainable sound. And so thank you for watching. Have fun with bassing.